Hooten's Arkansas football coming soon to a store near you once again. It's a summertime tradition in our state, and Chad Hooten joins us now on the Williams Tractor Hotline here on Ruscin and Zach. Chad, how you doing?
Great, guys. How are y'all?
We're doing good. So it's unique times because I don't know if any high schools got to do any kind of work during the spring as they usually do. Most of that takes place in April and May. So as you and your crew were talking to coaches, how was the kind of breakdown of teams different than it usually is?
Well, they didn't get to work with them in the spring, but they had them all throwing up on June the 1st. that's how you make up for lost ground, and they've been going at it ever since, you know, since June the 1st and working hard. And then there were some schools that found some ways. You know, we had some volunteer coaches and some dads working with some guys out there, and we're even saw some of that posted on Twitter. But, yeah, the coaches were disappointed not to be with their players. I'm sure high school and college, but you know, it was the same for everybody, hopefully, unless they were doing some stuff that they shouldn't have been doing.
Because that doesn't go everybody's on. That never happens.
Everybody's, well, occasionally it has been known to happen, but everybody should be pretty close to the same, on the same level and at the same pace. And, you know, and when it comes to learning their offenses and stuff, they'll all be together, you know, the same amount of time for everyone, hopefully.
Hey, nobody covers high school football closer than you in the state of Arkansas. I absolutely know. And Lurch, our producer, and I were just sitting here, and we were kind of lamenting the rivalry games. What is your maybe favorite under the radar? Everybody knows about the Salt Bowl, but under the radar rivalry game, what game, if you're going to go see one, is one that you want to go see because it is just that spectacular?
Well, you know, Nashville and Robinson out of Little Rock, and Nashville and Southwest Arkansas is big. Of course, Rising and Fordyce, there's only 9 miles separate those two towns in South Arkansas, and Fordyce, the home of Bear Bryant. Rising's got incredible tradition, kind of like Nashville. Springdale and Fayetteville back in the day, but that's all changed now, you know, with Harbor and Springdale, and of course, Bentonville and Rogers used to be big, but now you've got two schools in both of those towns. So Harrison and Mountain Home was big, really big back in the day. And, of course, you know, Bryant and North Little Rock, as big as the Salt Bowl is, it's been pretty one-sided, and it's going to continue to be one-sided with Bryant being the King Ben in 7A. And, of course, Benton's been great in 6A, but they're no match for Bryant. But North Little Rock has been, and that's been a good rivalry.
So let's talk. We're talking with Chad Hooten from Hooten's Arkansas Football here on Ruscin and Zach. Let's do a little breakdown here. Give us an idea who you've got at the top of 7A. Is Bryant still number one?
Yeah, no question, no question, Derek. They're the team to beat. You know, last year we were getting ready to shoot photos of that state championship game, and my brother sent the coach at Bryant a text: "Hey, who are some of the guys coming back? Give us some numbers." And he listed like 13 guys that were starting that were underclassmen on just a dominating, one of the most dominating teams probably since the Springdale 2005 team. Gus's Fab Five up at Springdale, probably the best team in the state since that time, and arguably the best defense in school history or in state history over at Bryant. And they've got over half their starters back, and I think everybody's chasing them. Bentonville may be the one team that could challenge Bryant a little bit this year, but otherwise, you know, North Little Rock's falling off, got a new coach. Fayetteville may surprise some people, and I think Bentonville West is probably a top five team as well, but they're all chasing Bryant.
Nobody does this like you guys do. In the lower classifications, one of my favorite postseason tournaments is the 4A because it is just the first two rounds of the 4A playoffs are just incredible. Who have you got, you know, 6A down? Give me some guys and teams to keep an eye on.
Okay. Well, in 6A, we're actually, you know, Rick Jones has left Greenwood. So it's that opens things up for a lot of people. And Benton, which played them in the state finals again last year, is going to be certainly a team to watch in 6A, as well as Greenwood. I mean, new coach, but they're not going to fall off too much, we don't think, it down at Greenwood. Wake Hamilton's coming on. West Memphis has just hired a new coach, which is going to make them a lot better. Pulaski Academy and Little Rock Christian, the two private schools, I think, are the class of 5A. And in 4A, Joe T. Robinson out of Little Rock won it last year. Look out for the Ozark Hillbillies. Could they be making it back to War Memorial this year? Shiloh was there last year, could return. I mentioned Nashville. great football town, is another one in 4A and AAA, Harding Academy. Your Wildcats, Ruskin, ranked right at the top of 3A, and Osceola is up there as well, played for it last year. Prescott's always good. Hoxie out of Northeast Arkansas, a little bit maybe under the radar, a team to watch. And then in AA, the Redbugs again. Talk about a team that won it all. Fordyce won AA, the smallest classification a year ago, and they've got, oh, it's incredible, a bunch of guys coming back, not only this year but the next. Junction City's always good. Girden Go Devils will be in the mix in 2A. And you know, you're talking about 2A, 3A, 4A, and you mentioned reaction to the coronavirus a minute ago. Just think about this. If they were to push football to the spring, guys, and these 4A through, say Shiloh returns to the state championship game, they'll play 15 games, right, in the spring.
Mm-hmm.
And then say they have another great run in the fall and they play another 15 games. That'll be 30 games. They won't play in January. They won't play at Christmas. That'll be 30 games in like 40-something weeks. So there's talk that if some reason it doesn't happen this fall, that they'll try to abbreviate the season in the spring and play fewer games, because that would be a lot of ball games in a short amount of time, which would be fun, but a whole lot for kids.
We're talking with Chad Hooten from Hooten's Arkansas Football. I you mentioned earlier talking about Bentonville West, and I think this is a story that gets largely overlooked in the fact that this program was nothing 5 years ago, and in every year but one, the last game of the year against Bentonville has decided who was the one seed coming out of the 7A West.
Yeah, and it could do that again. You know, we think, again, I mentioned Fayetteville, and of course Chris Wood's Harbor team will be in the mix as well. But, yeah, Bentonville West, kind of like Harbor, you know. Harbor, in their second season of football, played for a state championship, I think won it in their fourth season, maybe, won it all. And Bentonville West is chasing that. And certainly they had the unfortunate of running into Bryant in the second round, but played Bentonville again for the conference title last year, and the Tigers were quite a bit better that night. But Bentonville West has really played great football in their first 4 years of football. Won three games that first year, then 9 the second season, mm-hmm. and 7 the past 2 years up at Bentonville West. Coach Pratt's programs already established in just 4 years.
Chad, you sent me a screenshot of the magazine, which comes out next week. Got Sam Pittman on the cover. Now, last year, and I'm going to give you a mulligan here, you had a picture of the former head coach in it with a question mark and a question that said, better.
Yeah. Yeah, we thought there was no way, right?
It'd
be better after the first year, but it was really bad, and back-to-back two-win seasons, worst in Razorback history, and we just didn't think there was any way that they could not have been better, and they weren't. And but Sam Pittman, man, everybody loves him, and the one thing about Morris was that he was able to recruit some. But, man, Sam Pittman is a recruiting machine. We know that about him. And, you know, Arkansas should be better. There's no doubt, we think, this time for sure. Certainly looked to be better at quarterback. Great on offense at receivers. And of course, Rakeem Boyd could be as good as any in the SEC. And then, though, on defense, you know, all kinds of question there. But what a great hire by Coach Pittman. To surround himself with great players. And Browse, you know, all they need on offense, I think, to be able to score quite a few points is a better offensive line. And you've got two pretty good offensive line coaches on staff now, because you know Pittman will be in the mix there. And so Arkansas should be able to score, hopefully slow down teams a little bit. But, man, just a lot of deficiencies there and a whole lot of question marks. But Coach Odom was a great hire and said some really great things in Hooten's Arkansas football about his recipe on developing a top 20 defense at Arkansas, which they will need in the days ahead for sure.
Well, it's interesting you bring that up, because we spend a lot of time talking about offense here, and really a lot of shows do. I don't hear a lot about the defense and about Barry Odom. So just what are some things you took away from that conversation with him?
Well, you know, he understands that, you know, he's from Ada, Oklahoma. He's been around the program. He understands the Razorbacks. He's known Pittman. He's excited about Pittman and his leadership and his planning and his communication, and that the fact that Coach Pittman wants to make Arkansas proud, and he's bought into that vision, I think. And He wants to be here to move the program forward, and he thinks that that's what's happening with Coach Pittman, and he's excited about it, and had some really good things to say, and I think he's excited about his guys and developing guys, which is something that previous defensive coordinators probably haven't done a great job of doing. If you just look at the number of guys that have signed and the progress that they've made, I know that Sosa Aguim, I thought, was probably the best high school football player I'd ever seen in 30 years of watching players, just incredible athleticism. And I don't know that a lot of people would say the progress he made was disappointing, that he wasn't a whole lot better. He was certainly bigger, but I don't know how much he progressed as a player. Certainly a great talent, a guy that got drafted and still has that ability. But as far as the development, I think a lot of people have thought that Arkansas hasn't done that. It's been 6 years since Arkansas, fielded a top 10 really good defense, when Pylon, Spate, and Trey Flowers were there. Coach Odom said that, talent matters, he believes in the Razorback brand and that they're going to be able to develop players and recruit players. And he says it's an honor for the opportunity to coach at Arkansas and to coach with Sam Pittman.
Chad, one of my favorite parts of your magazine, or when you guys sit down and you rank the top 50 in-state players, and you rank them 1 through 50. And I want to ask you specifically about the top end of this year's senior class, in particular Landon Rogers, who just decommitted from Arkansas last week, and sort of where Arkansas high school football is, because we've had a couple of years here the last few years where there have been some top-end talent that's gone out of state. Now the guys seem to be sort of gravitating back towards Fayetteville.
Right. And a great job by Coach Pittman. The high school coaches talk about the contacts they've already had made. He wants everybody on his staff recruiting Arkansas, and they have really done that, and the high school coaches feel a whole lot better about Sam Pittman than they have the last couple of coaches the Razorbacks have had. And you mentioned Landon Rogers, quarterback at Little Rock Parkview, big tall kid. Drayton Norwood, his cousin, of course, Trey, is over at Oklahoma, and a guy that wanted to play for the Razorbacks but never got an offer. And I'm like, this is a guy
how
that's
does
getting
that
offers
happen,
from teams.
Chad?
Well, the story is that they came to watch him play twice, and they didn't think he was physical enough to play in the SEC. Every time I saw him play, and every high school coach he talked to was, yeah, he didn't play physical because no one was dumb enough to run his way and get. they knew they had no chance. But he was running down guys on the opposite side of the field because of his incredible speed and athleticism. And the night that I saw him go through the great North Little Rock defense and make about eight guys miss and then outrun the rest of them, I was like, this is incredible. And when all the schools that had offered him, including Oklahoma, had offered, and Arkansas sitting there and saying, yeah, I don't think he's physical enough for the SEC, it was mind-boggling. Hopefully they can get his cousin, who's a great one, now down at Fort Smith Northside. And there's just so many. There's another great group of players in this state again, and it seems like Coach Pittman's made it a priority, and of course his Georgia ties and just being around. He has literally been coached in 10 different states, and finally has landed his dream job as head coach of the Razorbacks.
All right, so the magazine comes out next week. Is that correct?
Yes, it'll be on newsstands next week. You can look for Hooten's Arkansas Football. This will be our 28th year. It's 416 pages, more like a book.
Yeah,
more like a book. 416 pages, covers the Razorbacks, the SEC. We went out on a limb and picked Clemson to win the national championship this year.
Wow!
We rank every team in the nation as well, with a little preview on all of those, all the state colleges. And this year, 193 high schools, which is down because we've had several, dropped to 8-man football, and we won't get started on that, but anyway, it's still 416 pages, the world's largest preseason football book. Features Coach Sam Pittman on the front cover of Hooten's Arkansas Football. After 36 years and upteen stops and across 10 states, he's landed his dream job, and he's not looking back, and we're proud that he's on the hill in Fayetteville. I think he made a lot of grown men get moist eyes the day at the news conference talking about growing up, coming up to Lou Holtz's football camps, and just how genuinely grateful he was to have the job at Arkansas, unlike a couple of guys in the past who seemed to genuinely think that Arkansas was fortunate to have them. So everybody, I think, is excited about it. We're excited to have him on the front cover of Hooten's Arkansas Football, calling the Hogs on the front cover, and you can look for it next week. Should be in on all the newsstands around the state. Harp's Grocery, of course, great partner with Hooten's Arkansas Football. The Walgreens stores, Walmart, of course, in the Red Racks, as our old friend Paul Wills used to say.
Yeah.
And we're excited about it. Great to be on ESPN 99.5 today with you guys, Ruscin and Zach.
All right. Well, Chad, we always look forward to it. I know Zach and I call games, and you got to have that. You
got
to have it to do any prep work for any of your ball games that you work throughout the year. Thanks so much for coming on today.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Chad Hooten, Hooten's Arkansas Football, available wherever new stands are next week.
Man, I'm telling you, every time I hear his voice, it's just high school football's here.
Yeah. Yeah, and they got all the schedules in there, so you can look up quickly who's got who on September, whatever. Okay, you can look them all up. College schedules are in there, too. Although some of those are going to be changing soon, but, you know, they're still in there, so you can
check it out. Yeah, you can see what they would have been.
Yeah.
All right.